These scenes were filmed back in July in the MSF Nutrition Centre in Maradi. This little girl had been admitted to the intensive care unit. But the programme is now closed. On July 22nd, the Nigerian government issued a decree suspending MSF's authorisations to work in the region. At the time, 3,400 malnourished children were receiving treatment. 180 of them were hospitalised.
We continued treating the children already admitted to the programme until they had recovered and completed treatment. However, 10 weeks have passed, and if we calculate on the basis of 500 children admitted per week over 10 weeks, that's a total of 5,000 children who have not benefited from the treatment for malnutrition that MSF provides. That's 5,000 children, and one third of them should have been hospitalized.
The government offered no explanation when it suspended MSF's activities. The decision was particularly surprising considering Niger is a pilot country in the fight against malnutrition and had authorized MSF to set up a program using new preventive and therapeutic protocols. The preventive strategy is based on distributing pots of complementary food, a paste enriched with essential nutrients. In 2007, 60,000 children in Maradi benefited from this treatment over the seven-month dry season.
Interesting work has been developed in Niger. We're working in a conflict-free zone, and the government has modified the national treatment protocol for severe malnutrition to include ready-to-use feeding products. A factory producing plumpy nut was set up here, so favorable conditions really do exist in Niger. MSF had an opportunity to participate in a very interesting process, but if it is to really take hold, malnutrition not only needs to be acknowledged, there needs to be genuine political will to address this problem.
A new memorandum of understanding was drafted on August the 15th, but the authorities in Niamey have yet to sign it. In the meantime, the 13 nutritional treatment centres remain closed. More than 14,000 malnourished children have been treated in Maradi since the beginning of 2008.